Hello, I'm George. Welcome to Public Spot. On this episode, I will show you how I set up Localstack on my machine. Localstack is a mocking tool for AWS services. It's also used for performing dry runs, local testing and verification of infrastructure resources before spinning them up on an actual cloud environment. So, let's start coding. If you need to learn more about Localstack, I'll put a link on the description below on their GitHub repository so you can read through the documentation sometime later. So what I need is a Docker Compose file that I will use to easily spin up Localstack on my machine. So in here, I'll create a Docker Compose file. Now I'll open my terminal and start my Localstack. So the log suggests that all services are up and ready. I have REST API client installed on my machine, so let me just quickly create an HTTP file here. And then we can run a GET against the health endpoint of my local stack and then also see the list of supported AWS resources. The GET request returned HTTP 200, and in the response, you will see a list of all the supported services for Localstack. So now, what do I need to set up to be able to run Terraform commands and spin up my infrastructure on Localstack? What I need is a different provider definition that will have all my Localstack specific parameters. So in here, I'll create a Localstack directory, and inside this directory, I'll create a providers.tf. In the latest version of Localstack, all service endpoints are using the same port. So now if I run Terraform init and plan inside this Localstack directory, I expect them to run successfully, but I don't have any defined resources to create. It should just say no changes. So now let me pull out the old AWS resources that I set up from a previous episode. This is the infrastructure code that I've set up for the Lambda function that I created to automatically cycle the IAM access keys. And if you remember, I've set this Lambda function as a container. And for this exercise, for this particular episode, I will restructure this Lambda function into a standard plain Lambda function. So what I need to do is to copy the infrastructure and Lambda directories from the previous episode. So let's have a look at the new infrastructure directory in my workspace. So firstly, I need to get rid of the files that I don't need inside infrastructure as well as the Lambda directory. I also need to update this file, by the way, because we no longer need the AWS Lambda RIC. So what I need to do next is to go through every single Terraform config file and remove the ones that I don't need. Now, I need to make adjustments on my Lambda function for it to work on Localstack. So, if you remember, this Lambda function has been set up to talk to other AWS services like IAM and Systems Manager. So, my Lambda function needs to be updated to make sure that calls to other AWS services would work inside Localstack. So, Localstack sets an environment variable, and this is what I need to inject inside the Lambda function for it to work. So what I'm doing here is I'm pulling out the value of the Localstack hostname. I'm creating a new variable called Localstack hostname, and then I'm using that value to set up the endpoint URL. So now I need to update all calls to other AWS services to add a property called endpoint URL. So what you see here at line 19 and 40 is defining a property called endpoint URL. So if this is not defined, Boto3 will set the value using the actual AWS endpoint. So now that all my changes for the Lambda function is done, let's close all these tabs and start fresh. And then now we can start making our changes to our Lambda function resource in our Terraform code. So I need to remove all container related properties of my resource. Now I need to replace that with the properties of a standard Lambda function. For the source code hash property, I'll define a data reference to an archive file. Before running this data archive reference, I need to make sure that all the files inside my Lambda function are ready. So all the module dependencies defined inside my requirements.txt has to have been installed inside my Lambda directory. So now I need to update my data reference to set a dependency on this pip install null resource. And then I have to update the source code hash property of my Lambda function with a data reference to this archive file. So at this point, I'm ready to fire up my infrastructure on my local stack. But as an additional step, I need to copy the contents of my local stack providers.tf into the providers.tf file inside my infrastructure directory. So now let's run our Terraform commands. All my Terraform commands have run successfully, but there is a problem with this setup. If I push this out to AWS, my provider will still have the local stack entries in here, which obviously is not correct. To resolve this, I need to use Docker when running my Terraform commands. Let me first destroy the infrastructure that I've just stood up. Now, how do I run Terraform using Docker? I need to do several things. One is to pass a volume mount to my current directory and then set a working directory where I need the Terraform commands to be run on, the Docker image, and then the actual Terraform command minus the Terraform word. So we're getting a number of errors when we run the apply. So if I scroll up a little bit, the first error is the pip binary is not found. And then the second error is it's trying to call localhost 4566. So let's fix the first error on the pip install issue. So let's fix the second one. The second issue requires updating providers.tf. And I need to replace all references to localhost to the actual container name that we've defined in our local stack. So let's open our Docker Compose. I've defined my container name as localstack. So go back to providers.tf, replace all strings that say localhost to localstack. And then when I run my Terraform Docker commands, I need to pass the Docker network where my local stack is running. So let's go back to our Docker Compose, and our network is defined as local stack. So let's go back to my terminal and run our Terraform commands again. So our Terraform apply was successful. Let me go ahead and destroy the infrastructure. What I would like to do next is to write a shell script that will wrap the long Terraform Docker commands that we've been running. Save that. And then we need to change the permission of the file. Now let's give it a try. So it seems to be working. So now I can start implementing the fix to resolve the issue with the conflicting providers.tf. And then what I need to do is reinstate the old structure of the providers.tf inside my infrastructure directory. And then what I need to do next is to add an extra volume mapping to override the value of the providers.tf. So what I'm doing here is I'm mapping the value of the providers.tf that I've defined in my local stack and putting that inside the Docker container for my Terraform commands. So now let's go ahead and run our Terraform commands using that custom wrapper shell script. So the apply was successful and my infrastructure has been stood up on Localstack. I will set up my AWS CLI so I could run commands to query the status of my Localstack resources. And then when I run my AWS CLI against Localstack, I always need to provide an endpoint URL that points to the endpoint of my Localstack on my machine. So if my infrastructure has been stood up successfully on Localstack and I run a query against list access keys, I should be able to fetch some access keys for the test user. So let's go ahead and have a look. So our AWS CLI returned an empty access key data, which signifies that something is wrong in our infrastructure. Let's open a new terminal and inspect the Docker Compose logs of my local stack. We're missing an import on our Lambda function. In order to fix this, all we need to do is add an import at the top. And then go back to our first terminal. And then in here, let's run our tfls command. And then the apply was successful. So we know that the CloudWatch events is configured to run every 5 minutes. Our option while waiting for the time to lapse is to actually call the Lambda function manually. So let's go ahead and do that. So the manual invocation of the Lambda function appears to be failing. So if you go to our Docker Compose log, it says no credentials error, unable to locate credentials. This error appears to signify that the Lambda function is actually trying to call the actual AWS endpoint instead of the local stack endpoint. If we open our Lambda function, so the change that I've done here doesn't seem to be taking effect, and I suspect that's because the local stack hostname environment variable is not set up. So what I'm going to do is I will attempt to work around this error by defining a set of environment variables that are only defined when I run on a local stack environment. So what I will do is, in my infrastructure variables.tf, I'll define a new variable here and call it Lambda variables. And then inside my main.tf on my Lambda function resource, I'll define a dynamic block for the environment property for this resource. And now I'll create a new file called localstack.tfvars. And inside this file, I'll define region. And I'll define Lambda variables. And I'll set an arbitrary environment variable. And then I'll probably have to rename my input.tfvars to something else and dump it in the same directory. And now let's go ahead and update our infrastructure. If I run my Terraform command, I'll pass in a path to the local stack tfvars. So there's a syntax error in my Terraform command, so let's just quickly fix that. The apply was successful. Now let's try to run the AWS CLI to invoke the Lambda function. And then now let's have a look at the list of access keys for my user. One key was generated. Let's pause in here, wait for a few minutes, and when the next time we run this list access keys, we should see two access keys generated for this user. So that's at least 5 minutes passed. So let's go ahead and run this again. So we've got two keys generated. So one was for the manual invocation and the other one was for the scheduled run. And that's a wrap. As usual, let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Send me some likes and share this video if you find it useful. And if you could, subscribe and help me spread the word about this channel. Until next time, see ya.